play the high reads last time. So there's high potential of getting a treble.
Oh! Oh! All right, guys. We did something new. We did something different. We went ahead and bought one of the most expensive swim baits on the market. So this is the DRT. That is the Division Rebel Tackle Tiny Clash. And this is the Working Class Zero collab with them, Joy Thief Color. So this is a special edition Working Class Zero DRT lure. This is a JDM, aka Japanese style swim bait. It is a low float. And today we are going to be doing a swim test of it. So I have yet to ever try out one of these giant swim baits. I have yet to ever use a DRT or any sort of JDM product that is a swim bait. So today we're going to be testing out for the first time, kind of showing you the different styles that it has. It is a special swim bait. It is an eccentric swim bait. It says it right here on the box. But on top of that, it has 5 to 6 different style swimming motions. And it has even more when you buy the additional tail for it, which I have. I just didn't bring it with me for some reason today. We'll go ahead and, you know, fish this thing a little bit more. But today I just wanted to do a swim test, show you guys what it's all about. So let's go take a closer look at this thing, tie it onto my pole, and get out there. Alright guys, so now that we got this thing pulled out of the box, let's go and talk a little bit about it. This is going to be a 2 ounce 6.6 inch swim bait. Once again, it's a DRT Working Class Zero collab. It is the Joy Thief color. One really cool thing about it is it's got the detachable bill on it, so you can actually change it out, make it like a swim bait to a glide bait itself. And then additionally to that, you have the tail that you can swap out. Really cool, unique design about it. It has two different angles in the tail itself that help create different, I guess, propulsions underwater. I guess, you know, depending on if you want to use it as a swim bait or if you want to use it as a glide bait, that's definitely going to make a difference. So we're going to go ahead, try out the different motions, different techniques, pull out the bill, flip the tail, stuff like that, and show you guys what it looks like in the water. So let's get to it. All right, guys, I talked about how expensive this bait is, so I'm not going to be screwing around when I'm tossing it. We got 40 pound braid. We're going to be using my heavy setup, doing a polymer knot, get this thing going. A lot of times people use fluorocarbon with these. You can use 20 pound fluoro and usually be pretty good, but I don't have any of that with me. I haven't bought any yet, so when I get some, we'll go ahead and change the setup. In the meantime, we're just going to use what we have, and I'd rather go heavy than with like the 15 pound fluoro that I have at home. So trim this up, start tossing it, show you guys exactly what it looks like. Hopefully I get some close up and some slow motion angles, try to get some up close looks for you guys. All right, guys, we got the bill a little motion going. Now I'm gonna flip the tail real quick. And if you look, the tail actually has a little bit more of a downward angle when you go this way up top. So we'll try that out, show you guys what it looks like, see if it makes a difference. Try to find the best style to fish this $100 swim bait. Oh yeah, yeah, that is a lot better to get that tail V-in. And if you guys can see, when you pause it, it even kind of turns around pretty nice. I like this because it's so cool. You could, you know, you can use it as a swim bait. You can use it as a glide bait. You can use it as a, you know, wake bait. So it's really cool. You get multiple techniques. It's got like a weird little shake and pause to it that it has with the bill in it. So I want to pop the bill out real quick. You can see it you just kind of go sideways with it. You don't want to go straight down. You see it has these little notches that hold it in place. But you go at an angle with it, pops right out. Make sure I don't lose that because I think those bills go for like 50 bucks. Everything on these aftermarket are so expensive because they're so hard to come about. Oh yeah, that looks awesome. So that's with the V tail facing downward, no bill. Oh yeah, that's more of like that glide bait. As you can see in my reel, doing that little twitch that I actually learned from our boy Weston. He's actually over here trying to get it going himself. But he taught me how to kind of work these glide baits, and luckily I know how. Now I see why it's called a low float, because you know, you kind of add a little bit of weight, you move it a little bit faster, it might push it down depending on how you have that tail. I'm sure, let's try swapping out that tail again and see if it changes things. Right now that tail's kind of pushing it downward, and this one I feel like will keep it pushing upward, if you see. So this will act more like a wake bait versus the glide bait style. It's not going to go in the water, it's going to probably just stay right on top. So stays right on top. That tail actually stays almost completely out of the water. I really wish I would have brought the V-tail so I could show you guys, but I'll probably have to show you another time when I actually start fishing this thing. Yeah, that is really nice. I like this. I like this probably the best, to be honest. Between the bill being on and off, I like it better without the bill. As far as the tail goes, I think I like it better like this too. The other version kind of makes it more like a glide bait. This makes it more like a wake bait. So I can actually see my bait the entire time. It doesn't freak me out, because I am tossing, you know, an $89 bait. It's $89.99 retail. They resell anywhere from $150 to $200 because they are very limited. They usually sell out in about, I don't know, a second, 2 seconds. I was lucky enough to jump on their website in the middle of the night one night. It was 11 o'clock. And it looked like they had restocked on some stuff. Went to check the swim baits. Next thing I know, I actually saw that they had the Tiny Clash available, so I picked one up. And here we are today, testing out our first DRT Clash. It is the Working Class Zero collab once again, so it is a limited edition style. So it's really cool that the first one we got is limited. All right, guys, so enough screwing around. As you can see, the sun is going down, so enough kind of showing you how it swims. Maybe we'll have to show you another time underwater footage, but let's get to some fishing, see if we can pull one while we're out here.
All the reeds that they chopped down, it was probably the high reeds last time. So there's high potential of getting a treble.
So right outside the reeds, not too close. Oh! Dude, first cast, what?
What? I thought you were just doing a swim test today.
Dude, what? First cast. They love it.
Okay,
here, it's the size of this bait.
Oh my God.
It's the size of your bait. Oh, he's bleeding a little bit on the arm.
Oh no,
all right, quick Tiny Clash picture. All right, guys, I can't believe we first cast. I can't believe it, actually. It looked too money. That's why I threw it there. Wow. Holy crap. All right, guys. First fish on the Clash. Slow as can be, bro. Working it like a glide bait like you taught me. Wow. We literally just tossed this thing straight out right here, guys. Right outside the reeds, like I was saying. Just work it low and slow. And lo and behold, something just came up and nibbled at it, man, and I just kept it tight the entire time. So do these swim baits work? Yes. All right, everybody, so I'm not gonna waste your time anymore. We're just showing you casting and me not really catching anything or doing anything out there on the water. But as you guys could see, we were able to get a nice little idea of the different types of movements that that bait can create. We were able to see it, you know, with the bill, without the bill, swapping the tail. Another thing is the actual tail that I was talking about that I did not bring with me. This is that little, you know, V tail that they have for it. Instead of it actually sitting horizontal like that, the tail sits vertically, so it creates a little bit different of a motion. It kind of keeps the bait from moving its back end, I guess, as much as the tail that is on there right now. That kind of works as more of like a pivoting motion. But we will be testing it out later on with the V-tail. We will also be trying out a few different other swim baits in comparison to this video. So I'll be working on that in the future and getting ready to show you guys. I'm really excited because I got one bait that I know you guys are probably ready to see.
I'm not gonna let you know just yet what bait it is. You're just gonna have to wait and find out. But I'm excited about it, so I know you guys will be excited about it. But yeah, that's gonna be it for today, guys. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you're wondering where to get these baits and how to get these baits, I'm gonna go ahead and leave the links below as well. They are very hard to pick up. I will let you know that. But that's gonna be it. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.